Now, the real question is, how did I end up here? There I was in Naples, minding my own business, and I see a group of nurses disembark from a motor launch. And there, beyond the nurses, I see her. My girl, the Britannic. I'd toured her in Belfast before she was converted into a hospital. I had to see what the war did to her. I took the motor launch, bumped the pier a few times, and here I am. Now, question two. Did I tie up the motor launch to the ship before I climbed the ladder? This would have been the ideal spot to dump Harry. If only I'd known I'd be here in 4 months, I'd have waited. It would have been easier to get away with. Now, Claire, it's not too late with her.
Thank you.
Someone was playing games here recently. The medical staff must do all sorts of exciting things to keep themselves occupied on the outbound voyages. It must be great to have fun. Ah, splendid. I was beginning to think that they wouldn't be able to handle interior and exterior locations in a single build. Why these ropes? To what end are they sectioning off parts of the ship from me? The ship is here. I demand to see it all. Even third class get quite an upgrade on this ship. They have a larger smoke room on the newly added shade deck, and now their own enclosed promenade space. When this ship returns to ocean liner service after the war, it'll sweep Cunard under the rug. Those new gantry davits really do loom over us, don't they? The best compass to follow is your heart. Captain Bartlett is an admirable commander. He knows this ship well. Unlike most people, I actually trust his command of a ship. And believe you me, I have had my fair share of experience on this subject. I'm counting an additional expansion joint. Does this ship have three, four? These seem to be of a different design, too. Interesting how unchanged the forecastle is from the first two ships of the Olympic class. I suppose there's no need to change it. This isn't a passenger space. They've gutted it. The pipe organ, the beautiful wood paneling, the questionable blue flooring. The one comfort is that it's being kept safe from the Hun's brutish fist. Thank you. Gallipoli and the Dardanelles campaign. What a disaster that was. Here's a stack of memories I should probably begin repressing. The meaning of all these ropes everywhere. It's frankly a wonder to see how such a palace and triumph of appointment could be so rapidly turned over into an efficient medical facility supporting the greatest war we've ever known. Time for you to have some real fun. One could get lost in their own cabin on this ship. We're an extra deck down from the Regal Suite. I wonder who'd be occupying this cabin. Wounded officers, RAMC, perhaps the nurse matron, or Mr. Robin Darcy. Glad to see the pool is still being used. The Britannic deserves some joy in these dark years. Maybe I can get some laps in before the ship departs for Lemnos.